performance-based planning and programming. State Departments of Transportation, DOTs, Metropolitan Planning Organizations, MPOs, and operators of public transit are now required by U.S. DOT Performance-Based Planning and Programming, or PBPP, regulations to adopt a performance-based approach to planning. Specifically, they must coordinate on establishing targets in key national performance areas and document expectations for future performance. These targets must be reflected in MPO's Metropolitan Transportation Plans, MTPs, and in state's long-range statewide transportation plans. This video will provide a high-level overview of performance-based planning and programming for Transportation Performance Management, or TPM for short. You'll learn how performance-based planning and programming can help you, what state DOTs and MPOs are required to do, and what resources are available to help you implement it. You're probably already familiar with TPM, a strategic data-driven practice for achieving better transportation system performance that uses information about infrastructure conditions, travel time reliability, freight movement, safety, and air quality to help inform transportation investment decisions. Performance-based planning and programming takes TPM's main requirements and provides a recommended process for using them to enhance planning and programming. This process helps transportation agencies get the most from their limited funding and build the best case for transportation investments. And it makes for a more transparent and accountable process with the public, showing how their dollars are being invested as effectively as possible. Performance-based planning and programming is built around four simple phases. Strategic direction, or where do we want to go? Analysis, or how are we going to get there? Programming, or what will it take? And implementation and evaluation, or how did we do? Let's take a look at each of these phases. Where do we want to go? In this first phase of performance-based planning and programming, a transportation agency needs to focus on the strategic direction of their transportation program. Crosswalking their local goals and measures with the national goals and measures is a good way to start aligning their strategic direction with the performance-based planning and programming requirements. The first step encompasses the national goals and measures elements of TPM and will help guide their decisions. How are we going to get there? In this second phase, a transportation agency needs to focus on planning and analysis, especially during development of their federally required statewide or MPO-level long-range transportation plan. State DOTs and MPOs need to integrate the performance targets set within key goal areas and explain how plans and programs help achieve condition and performance. In addition, MPOs must assess their capital investments and developed strategies, as well as develop a financial plan for implementation, which are also good practices for states. This step corresponds with the targets element of TPM. What will it take? In this third phase, a transportation agency focuses on the programming of investments, or where money will be invested. These projects, which will be reflected in MPO and State Transportation Improvement Programs, TIPS and STIPS, can range from bridge construction and maintenance to traffic management strategies to other allowable projects. In this phase, state DOTs and MPOs will need to link investment priorities to their performance targets. To aid in determining what projects they fund, states and MPOs should determine how funding will be allocated upfront and take steps to implement the selected program of projects. This investment planning component of performance-based planning and programming corresponds with the plans element of TPM. How did we do? In this fourth and final phase of performance-based planning and programming, a transportation agency monitors and reports on progress. By evaluating progress, they'll be able to judge the effectiveness of their planning and programming decisions, and then can refine goals, measures, and targets on an ongoing basis to inform future investment priorities. This evaluation component corresponds with the reports and accountability and transparency elements of TPM. Importantly, performance-based planning and programming is intended to integrate well with an agency's existing transportation planning processes. For example, most states and MPOs already base their plans around qualitative goals and objectives. What's new is that now they must set performance targets related to those federal goals and measures, and then monitor and report on them. And while states and MPOs are required to develop performance-based long-range transportation plans and performance-based programs, STIPs and TIPs, it's important to note that decisions about which projects to select and fund remain at the state and local level. What do state DOTs and MPOs need to do, and by when, under performance-based planning and programming? Under MAP 21 and the FAST Act, the U.S. DOT has established national performance measures. States and MPOs now need to set their own performance targets in support of the national performance measures and their own goals. States are required to coordinate performance targets, as well as tracking and reporting on those targets to the maximum extent practicable with relevant MPOs. For each performance measure, MPOs can support the state DOT target or establish their own, no later than 180 days after the state sets its target. To foster common outcomes, MPOs may wish to, but aren't required to, set their targets at the same time as the states. Through required written agreements, state DOTs, MPOs, and public transportation providers need to cooperatively determine their respective responsibilities. These agreements specify what data is going to be used, who will collect it, how it will be shared, how targets will be coordinated and set, and how tracking and reporting on progress will occur. As mentioned earlier, target setting, tracking, and reporting will be an ongoing process. Federal transportation funds, such as funds for state planning and research and metropolitan planning, PL funds, can be used for performance-based planning for activities like data collection or the development of management systems. Working together, we can provide strategies to improve our nation and people's lives through great transportation planning. Download the companion document with helpful resources on performance-based planning and programming at www.fhwa.dot.gov/tpm/videos.